right then. Hold on. Today's synchronicities. What's up, Arcane? Sorry about that. Right when I started streaming, the doorbell rang, and it was this one. It was a package being delivered that had to be signed for. It's crazy, crazy, man. How you doing? Today I'm working on puzzle patterns. What's up, Chaos? New puzzle patterns for the new swordless dungeon. The theme of this dungeon, finally, oh my god. Finally what? What are we saying finally for? Kept saying you're offline? That's probably because I was. So this is gonna be, so the theme of this dungeon is the shield. You get the shield here. And then you use it to bounce things off of shield towers. Yay! Because I started early. Oh, right on. Yeah, so starting early is something I try for, but doesn't always happen. Where am I getting these cool ideas from? It's creative ideas just come, man. I don't know. I guess I'm inspired. I'm inspired by lots of other video games that I've played all my life. You know, it's probably subconscious mostly. It's probably mostly just subconscious stuff where like, I'm like, I don't realize it consciously, but I'm drawing from some Nintendo game I played 20 years ago, you know. Some ideas, I guess, probably come from creativity, pure creativity. But most of it, I think, is just inspiration. Nice. Yeah, you're home alone? All right, cool. You got full reign of the place. So yeah, we're gonna have a couple different patterns for the shield tower things. Thanks, Vale. What's up, T? So to start it off, let's put a push pillar, shield tower in the middle of the screen. What other games have you worked on? None that you would know. My last video game I worked on was called Hero Bash. It was a MOBA for iPads and iPhones, and it failed to make any money, so it was like a real big failure in life. So but it taught me a lot of great lessons, and I shared them all on a Gama Sutra post. Other than that, I've made games for iPhones and iPads in the 2010s. And then the last time I made games actually was in the early 2000s and the 1990s when I started making games. And that's in the 90s, I made games for DOS and for the early Windows. And I had my own company doing that. And I tried to sell it myself and it didn't really succeed selling it myself. So I got this publisher, and the publisher sold it okay, but I only got like 5% of the profit. So it was kind of like, I don't know, it wasn't really that fulfilling. So I was kind of like really disillusioned with the whole gaming industry. So I took 10 years off, basically. I worked for companies too. I worked for Trilobite a little bit, which they made The Seventh Guest and The 11th Hour. I also worked for small companies in Southern Oregon where I'm from. So yeah, my history is kind of a patchwork history of working on games and not working on games, but now I'm back to making a game that I freaking love. This is so great. This is the first video game where I designed everything, did all the art, made all the music, designed the game, wrote the story and all that. And it's so fulfilling, man. It's so fulfilling. This is the best, this is the most fulfilling creation I've ever made, Songbringer. I'm so excited for it. Every day I'm thankful for it. I'm so thankful that the Kickstarter succeeded. I'm thankful that you guys are there watching me stream, supporting in a way. I am really, really excited to be making this game. It's to say it's fulfilling is like an understatement, but really it's one of the best words I could possibly think of to fit the feeling that I generally have. Yeah, right. Yeah, doing everything yourself is satisfying. It takes long. It takes a long time to do everything yourself, but if you're one of those people that likes doing stuff yourself, you're a DIY style person, making your own video game all yourself is freaking awesome. So, yeah, there's that. So I want to put some, so yeah, this is what this pattern's going to be like. There'll be a shield tower here in the middle of the screen, and then there'll be a push pillar right in front of it. And then you have to push the pillar out of the way so you can let the shield tower hit you. So let's do a push pillar right below it. Yeah, that's why you don't use an engine. Yeah, that's awesome, right? Yeah. I used to do that too when I was younger. I would make my own engines. You kind of had to back in the day, in the DOS days. But it was I didn't do it just because I had to. It was because I wanted to. I loved creating my own engines back then. Today, I would still love creating my own engine, but it's almost a choice. It's like, okay, do I want to create my own engine or do I want to create a game? Because creating an engine takes a long time. So yeah, this is kind of what's going to happen. And then we'll put some stuff around this. Put some bushes around it. So do you use an editor to place the items, or you have to input code to make it happen? It's all code, man. There's no editor. Yeah, nice. You coded a map editor too, right on, T. That's also satisfying, right? Make your own map editor. So we'll put a bush to its left. Another bush on its right. Three bushes. So let's see if that's kind of what the pattern is supposed to be here. Oh, I gotta make sure that these shield things don't shoot through the bushes. Huh? Yeah, nice. Yeah. Right on, Teague. Okay, it's the one thing though that sucks so far about this is that it needs a little bit more path so you can see that there's clearly that this is a push pillar in front of the shield tower, so let's do that. Nice. You are getting close. Look at that, man. 3,000 points already. Right on. I admire you guys' dedication. Jonah just won a free copy of the game for his friend too. Yeah, good. So that hits. It bounces off. It does shoot through the bush, but at least it hits the bush on the way back, so you can't cheat. Okay, let's try this way too. Just bounces off, but doesn't hit back. So you have to push this pillar here, and then let it hit you. Cool. Awesome. That's really all I wanted to see there. I guess that one's done. Shit, that was easy. All right. So the next one, I want to do kind of similar. But you have to light some fire pillar things on fire. You can do it right here, Chaos. You do a command to spend your points, but you need at least 1,000 points to try and for the raffle. It's like a raffle. It basically just gives you a percentage chance to win. If you bet 1,000 points or whatever, you can try, but it gives you 25% chance. If you bet 4,000 points, though, you get a guaranteed. So we'll do an unlit pillar for this next pattern. Challenge accepted. Okay, so that one works. Let's go to the other pattern. Might be this one. No, it's not that one. So that's number three. Let's go to number two. All right, cool. So the goal of this one is to do kind of a similar thing, except that you have to use these fire pillars. Okay, so I want those to go down after there. Unlit pillar tile. So we'll do if the area pause dot z is less than or equal to 2 here. I used to, but I only made maps for games. Right on. Will you change the ground texture? Oh no, this isn't the tower. No, this isn't the tower right here. The tower I'm talking about is that thing in the middle. This is a shield tower thing. No, the ground texture is meant to be like this. Yeah. Do I have the right pillar here? World. Fire pillar. Oh, it's the fire pillar, not the unlit pillar. Oh. Oh, whoops. Whoops-a-doo. After a specific point of skill, it's more the imagination of the coder how good it gets. Yeah. Yeah, it is, right, T? Okay, this is... It's like it already... Why is it already down? Oh, because... Create fire pillar. I think this is doing this because I've been everywhere in this dungeon. Free parking! Wow. At least it wasn't 7 points. What's that method where it restore tiles, maybe? Oh, restore tile data. Here it is. So we want to do never in never restore gates in the swordless dungeon. There really are no gates in these swordless dungeons. So if area, well, if this, so if has bits flags k flag swordless. Open equals false. Nice. Cool. Oh, it doesn't go down though. What happens if I light it and then go off the screen? I just want to do push pillars instead. Oh, there it goes down? Come on. What? In-game item trading update. 2011, we added a feature to Steam that enabled users to trade in-game items. Yeah. A number of gambling sites started leveraging. Okay, so why are you saying that that killed a couple billion dollar market? Oh, you're saying it killed the gambling? So I want these fire pillars to go down when they're done, but only in this kind of dungeon. There it is. Lower the fire pillar. Activate complete. I guess we'll do this. We have a fire pillar here. Use trade bots to obtain items. Yeah. Wow. Sucks if you're a gambling site. I'm glad it's not affecting any like legitimate businesses though. So these do have activate change, activate zero, activate complete. So we can do the same thing here in activate zero HP. So we're going to lower the fire pillar. Under certain, well, in the swordless. So, and if area has bits, area, get flags, swordless, just lower the fire pillar. Oh, since they allowed miners to gamble. Baited them? Wow, yeah, that's not cool. That happen? Oh, it didn't even trigger that. Okay. Why not? It might have gotten into this code, it just didn't. It like might have removed a component before it did this or something. Let's see if we hit that. What? Oh, this already has 0 HP. Buggy. Why? What? Yeah, I just said I'm streaming. Okay, so it already had 0 HP, so that kind of explains part of it. Oh, they pretended they just found it. Dang. Scammers. Okay, let's see what's going on with this logic. Man, fixing bugs always stops creativity. I just want to be creative and create these different patterns, but... this bug is stopping me. Oh, that's called the unlit fire. What? Ah, screw this. I'm just gonna work on the pattern that I wanted to work on instead of fixing whatever the hell is wrong with this. Who cares? Just make the pattern. So I'm thinking that it says this area has two different doors, two different entrance ways. And so I want to make it so you have to come in one of these doors or one of these pathways and light some things on fire, which then allows you to go to the other door. Like you come in at that, at this door, you light some things on fire, and that goes ju 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 goom, and then it allows you to like get over, come back through, come through this door, and then get shot by the pillar. Two doors, you can just set make a little pathway to go between them. Okay, this is gonna be kind of a complex pattern, but it'll be worth it to have a cool puzzle. Okay, off the bat, the first thing we need to do is make, where is it? Constants. Pattern flag, puzzle. Shield 2 has min wall thickness because we're gonna need pretty much all of it for this one. Got a lot of room now. So the next thing is to set up this pattern so okay, so shield 2, we want to put fire pillars. Fire pillar. And this is 2 below. One to the left. Okay, we need to know if or wait, let's go int. Int flip. We need a bool west and east. Bool west is equal to this has door. Okay, dir west. East is this has door. Okay, dir east. Flip equals if west or not east, then flip is -1, otherwise flip is 1. Okay, so this is going to be W2 plus W1 times flip. Let's call this flip X because we might have a flip Y at some point. All right, there. So, okay, we're putting this half of the pattern on the left because of how this room is set up. One, two, let's go two, one more. And then up, da, 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 da. Let's go maybe 3 deep or so. 3, 4, 5, See how this is looking. Yeah, okay, this is kind of what I'm imagining. So, the point is to be able to light these things on fire. And then they go down. So I'll fix that bug later, getting them to go down. So once they're all down, then you can stand down here and get hit by the fire pillar. Now we just need to surround the fire pillar thing with bushes. I think I gotta draw a pattern thing. No, is it pattern something? Pattern line, pattern shape. Yeah, I think it's pattern shape. Shape rectangle, width 3, height 3, okay, tile bush. See if that, I don't know if that'll work or not. Oh, I did. Okay. And set up a center point. So this whole thing can pivot off that. All right, so after we do this pattern shape, we want to do a pattern line. Don't trust the bot. So x0 is going to be center dot x, centered. Center.x, y0, center.y, center.y, actually we should probably do a width, or radius, nah, probably just radius. Or like a int. I guess just radius X, radius Y. This is gonna be center Y minus radius Y. If tile, K tile, bush, set tile, K tile, none. I should draw a line straight down the middle. we did. But what if we set the radius a little higher? Yeah, it still didn't work. Turn all these off for a minute. Why aren't you working? Pattern line? Nice, Chaos. There are secret passages already. There's lots of them. In fact, there's a secret passage in this very dungeon. Where's it at? Let's see if we can find it. I'm cheating, of course. But cheating is the fastest way! Oh, there it is! Okay, so here is the secret path. There's a secret path here. There's secret paths in caves as well, so there's lots of secret paths that you can walk, like, some of them have walls, you have to bomb through walls. Sometimes you just find these secret paths like this where you can just walk along them. Sometimes these secret paths with the bushes like this have to be walked at night, so you can only do this at night. So there's lots of secrets already in Songbringer. Okay. Why didn't this pattern line work? Pattern line, if is tile, if tile, set tile, set tile. Oh, because I did the Y zero. Let me just correct myself here. If Y zero, it's greater than Y1. Swap Y0 and Y1. Same for X. What about the other ideas? Sound like good ideas, man. Y0, Y0, X0, X1, cool. Let's do that for pattern line, this pattern line thing. And this should become a function. I mean, define, so I don't have to do this twice. A multiplayer version? There already is a multiplayer version. There's a local co-op multiplayer. There will never be online multiplayer, though. It's too much work. Area, pattern, line. It's not really the right type of game to do online multiplayer. Okay, there we go. So now we got both those. We're using that. I should swap those two variables correctly. What's this? Oh, right, I know it is. Okay, let's see if that worked now that it swapped those variables. Should put a line in the middle. Yeah, cool. We got this nice line going through here. Yay! Now I want this radius to be bigger. Let's go with a whole 7. Nice, that's looking better. Think it could be a little wider though, maybe 9. And let's center it a little lower. Yeah. Okay, now the other fire pillar paths can be lines as well. So we'll start at center.x plus radius x times flip x, and then it goes to center.x plus 2 times flip x, so it gets close but doesn't quite touch the shield tower. And then y0 is always center.y. Center.y, if tile, k tile, bush, k tile, none. There, I should draw a line of pillars there on the left. Oh, it didn't work. What? What? Oh, because I did K-Tile 9. It's supposed to be K-Tile. Fire pillar. Why is my computer's fan going the whole time? Must be a hot day, I guess. Or I'm just running the game a lot. Cool, we got that line. Let's do another line. Starting at center.x plus 2 times flip x. Same thing here. This goes center.y. This goes center of y minus 2. And we'll do another line. Yeah, cool. One more line. This time it goes from center.x plus 2 to center.x. Center.y minus 2, both those. And now that should be complete. We have a nice little zig, kind of zaggy line going from the one edge to the middle there. It's a pretty simple pattern. You know, this is not very hard to figure out as a player. You like, you know, this isn't going to take you very long to figure out, but we need to go one more. Oh, we can't do that. Okay, I should mention what all these are. This one. This is a vertical line of fire pillars down from center. This is horizontal line of fire pillars into center. And this is the vertical line of nothing down center from shield tower. Nice. Cool. So now the point is you just light this on fire. Down so you can get hit by this shield tower. Alright, so next thing is we would be to fill in everything we don't need. So this whole area will become bushes. Actually, shoot. We should do that at the very beginning. Arcane, 38 points. So we need to track if we have a north path, as well as the south path. Fill the whole thing with bushes. As long as we're not on one of the pathways. Oh. Yeah, this is gonna have to get smarter. Based on. I guess we can just draw a path through things. Yeah, okay. We'll figure out how to draw a path through things afterwards. If north and y is greater than h2, and this is x center. Leave that path open. Let's like make all these. If south. If east. Okay, so that should leave some paths to start with, but then now we need to make sure, after this, we need to make sure that all the paths work, no matter what type of shape this room actually is, what type of doors it actually has. Yeah, this is exactly what I want for this type of room. So this room works flawlessly. If these oh wait, I would need to put something here. Some water maybe. Yeah, let's put some water there. Center dot x, center dot y minus radius y. It's gonna be k tile water. Oops. Way too low. How to get down there? What? Center dot y minus radius dot y. I guess we don't need that anymore. What? Center dot y minus two. Oh, it's half of radius dot y. Ah, guess we did need this. Yeah, there we go. There's a little thing blocking you so you can't. Quite light that thing on fire. Yeah, you just can't do it. There we go. Okay, so that's the point. You come in from this side, and you light this on fire, all these things go down, and you come over here and get shot by this thing. Boom! Activate this puzzle. Simple puzzle, but oh wait, it didn't work. God, what's going on here? It's freaking me out. freaking me out. It's freaking me out, freaking me out. Might have to do with the shield tower. My shield tower. Shit, maybe we'll just go up. Because, yeah, this shield tower is really fucking it up. Let's do this horizontal line. Center on Y plus one. And then the vertical line down is going to be plus one. So there. Make that a little more friendly. But why? It might be the shield thing that's like messing up those fires. By this. And activate the puzzle. Sweet. Okay, so this overall works, but there's gonna be some things where it's not gonna work, like if it's the wrong shape of room. And of course the fire pillar's not going down at first, it's kind of confusing, so. Let's fix these things up a little bit. Let's start by checking in what I got so far, because that's a good progress made. Closed door strings, area, blah, 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 blah. Okay. Swordless shield, 1, 2, 3. New swordless comment. Okay, I don't need to check this in. I don't know. Not sure what to do to solve that yet. Probably should come up with a more simple approach that's easier to understand. Swordless dungeon 2 puzzles started. Okay, let's handle the first case. I gotta find a world where this pattern would break. So I'm gonna start. Put myself just at position of dungeon 5, start dungeon 5, and then we go just try some other world seeds until we get a pattern 2, which is broken. And we'll fix it. So what I'm looking for is like either a dead end or a north and a south opening. That's the third one. That's the first one. Let's make sure that still works. Yep. Aha, here's a dead end one. Okay, so you can clearly see this one's broken. It's like, okay. Oh, I didn't know it was that thick. I got my radius wise all wrong there. Okay, so let's fix this one. This is radius X. Shift it down one. And okay, so now we need to like draw some kind of path, like an opening. I'm gonna do is create a little area right here where there's an opening. So we need to capture radius X, probably radius Y, and flip X. And center, probably. Okay. So these are pathways from doors. This is gonna be small open area near the end of fire pillars. Fire pillar snake. Let's call it a fire pillar snake from now on. This kind of looks like a snake. Okay, so that's going to be if X is greater than or equal to, which is, let's start with less than or equal to, oh, greater, oh shit, it depends on flip X. Okay, the way to make it not depend on flip X is to do a delta. So absolute value of, okay, so we do like a center point near the snake. So open point X is gonna be center dot X plus radius X, shift it down one, plus 1, 2 times flip X, open Y. It's going to be center dot Y. It's just center dot Y. Sal Dongs, what's up, man? How you doing? So if the absolute value of X minus open X is less than or equal to 1, and absolute value of Y minus open Y less than or equal to 1, then return. I should put a little tiny landing area there at the end of this. What's new, man? What you working on today, Saldos? Sweet, we got it. All right. So here's our little landing area. I guess we'll put Y plus 1 there. No, I guess we don't need, well, yeah, let's do Y plus 1. Yeah, okay, so now we got this landing area where now we just need to draw a little path. bugs here to figure out. Anyways, so now we need to draw a line from the middle of that down to here. And this... Let's think about this. There's lots of cases where you need to draw some kind of crazy path. Take a screenshot here. Think about this for a second. What's up, Vegas? How you doing, man? No, Buegas, I started 2 hours early today. Thank you, Amarok. Okay, so let me show you what I'm thinking here. This has to be a flexible algorithm depending on the world, depending on all of the algorithms that create this world. So there's a chance that, you know, there's a chance that there's an opening up here on the top. There's a chance there's an opening over here. There's a chance there's an opening here. There's a chance there's all four openings. You know, you never really know. So the thing is, if you have... if we have two openings, one is in the north and one is down here, then we have to draw some special lines. I'm starting to think of like an algorithm. Okay, this is what we could do. Let's do a red color. Right? Yeah, puzzles. Making puzzles in a procedurally generated game is tough. I mean, making puzzles in a normal game is a lot easier. You can be like, okay, here's my world. Here's exactly where the entrances are. And I'm going to make a puzzle that works like this. But when it's a procedurally generated game, dude, you got to really think of like a bajillion different edge cases and solve problems creatively and stuff. It's not easy. Okay, but this is what I'm thinking. Like, if there's this concept. There's a line that looks like about like this. Imagine a pathway that's like this. Could be open paths, like around this little, where that line is. And then depending on what's needed, it would cut out sections. So like in this particular area, we don't need any of that. Why can't I delete that? Delete, what the fuck? What? Was that not selected? Yeah, so we would delete that and then delete this, and we would have a pathway that goes through these woods here so you could get to this. I know, right? Yeah, it's crazy logic. You're debugging proc gen issues that only occur in some seeds. How do you know which seeds to check? Well, I'm just trying to think of what situations would break the puzzle. And then in this particular example, all I did here was I started with seed Xanadu, and Xanadu produced the puzzle that worked perfectly on the first try. And so that's what I developed this puzzle on. And then I switched to seed Wizard, and it gave me this situation. So I'm trying to fix this situation, and this helps me know other things that could break too. And I think this idea here of doing like this pathway and then just cutting out the sections that aren't needed. I think that could work for all situations. What's up, Jonah? Yeah, this is the good old Xanadu. It's like my default test world. Okay. Oh, you know what? The easiest way to start this is to just simply draw this line everywhere. Oh, and this could be easy to do with XDYD. So this could be like a open path or narrow pathway as needed. Yeah. Right. And but I mean really in general the concept is to try and think of the situations that would break the puzzle and then try and find world seeds that exhibit those problems and then solve them. So but the thing is to try and you already understand this. It's like to understand what could break your puzzle and then fix it. Or yeah, sometimes it's just waiting for reports on buggy seeds, 'cause like sometimes you don't think of a situation until it actually happens, and you're like, oh my God, yeah, that's that world seed has that, and blah blah blah. Okay, so we'll do a narrow pathway as needed. This will be int xd equals abs x minus w2, no, center dot x. Yes. YD, y minus center y. All right, so if XD equals radius x shifted down one plus two. You do, you have enough for one try. Return. So if XT equals oh man, wait. That would give me XD equals all of those or all of those. Oh, okay, so this would be XD equals this, and YD equals the other thing. No. And yeah, okay, and then Y is less than or equal to this is getting long. I'm trying to think maybe I should simplify this variable here. But it's radius y. Y is less than or equal to. Oh no, if y is less than or equal to center dot y plus radius y plus two. And y is greater than or equal to center dot y minus radius minus two. Okay, let's see if that gives us the two lines. Yeah, cool. They gave us those two lines. Alright, so we've got a line here and a line over here. So now I'll do the horizontal lines and then do the logic to turn off the lines that aren't needed. So if yd equals radius y, shift down one plus two. And x is less than or equal to center x, radius x. X is greater than or equal to center x, radius x. That should give us the other lines. This is definitely a difficult puzzle. This is definitely, I've been working on this single puzzle here for like an hour. But it'll be worth it. It'll be worth it to have this cool puzzle. Really, this puzzle shines when you've got two areas. Yeah, so now we've got a line there, a line here. Yes. I'll be right back. It's hot as hell today. There you go. Got the command. The command is a steam key. There's no try. Yeah, is this the steam topic? Yep, talking about that, huh? Still. Oh, Buegas. Oh. Damn, sorry, man. But since you're so brave to try, I'm going to give you some points. Get you started back on your path to trying again. Yeah, Teak tried like so many times. We felt bad for him so many times. Like, no, Teak, don't do it again. Yeah. Nice. There, you got some more points. There you go, see? Fortune favors the bold. You were bold enough to try. Okay, so how do I turn off certain paths? So this one, we only need... only need this bottom line and this line because we have south and we have... oh, we need... west. All right. I'm going to start by simplifying this variable radius x shifted down to shifted down one. Earlier today, you read that Unity's net value jumped something like 150 million as it rolls. A result of Pokemon Go? Wow. Not only did Nintendo's value jump, but so did Unity's value just because of Pokemon Go. And neither of those companies made Pokemon Go. That is crazy. What's up, Cottage X? Oh, there you go, dude. Chaos is giving Teak points. A Clone Geek, you're like, I'd come back to the stream, everybody's giving, like, all this kindness. It is a lot of kindness. Way to be kind, guys. It's awesome. Int radius S. Let's go radius. or 2x. Or 2y. And then we should be able to just do that and that. Oh no, you tried again. Oh. I was hoping you would wait. Oh man, bummer. Two in a row, it's gotta suck, man. Ugh. Thank goodness for anesthetic cough drops. Oh, yeah, it is. Oh, don't say it. Don't think it's your fault, Clone Geek. It's not your fault. You know what I just figured out? It doesn't need to be. I don't need to chop off all these different paths and stuff. I just need to do this only if. Only if needed. So if we have. We have only one opening. Yeah, so if we have only one opening, like this particular room here, we need this whole pathway thing. Same thing here. If we had one opening there, we would need the whole path. If we had one opening here, we would need the whole path. If we had one opening here, we could use the whole path too. So yeah, if there's one opening, but if there's two openings, so I guess we'll count the number of openings. And number of openings equals north and south. So if number of openings is one, we always need this. Or so if number of openings is greater than one, then we have a situation where if we have, I guess it's just, if we, as long as we, if we don't have south, then we definitely need this. There's another situation though. If we don't have South. Okay. What are the other situations? The logical situations where this pathway would be needed would be if. I was thinking maybe I should just list these out. Oh, I got it. It's easier to focus on the situation we do need. We don't even need any of that stuff. If we just go, as long as, if this situation is not met, where we have south and east or west, super easy. We don't even need number of openings. Okay, so this should work now. What is this puzzle about? This is a swordless dungeon. So in the swordless dungeons, you don't have your sword, and it's mostly puzzle based. So the whole point is to solve puzzles, right? The gate item inside this dungeon is the shield. So you get in the swordless dungeon, you don't have your sword, you find this shield, right? The shield is something where you can reflect like this, see that? You let things hit you. As long as you're not moving, your shield bounces things off. So the point of this puzzle is just to, the point of this is to, it's, the swordless dungeon is essentially a meta puzzle. You have to solve like three different puzzles to get the boss door to open up. So this puzzle is just that. It's just part of a meta puzzle. It's really all it is. Once you solve all the puzzles, you're ready to go and you get out of this dungeon. So yeah, okay, we got this situation worked. Okay, let me show you guys the first puzzle works really nicely in Xanadu. Get points one. Oh man. So yeah, in Xanadu, where is this at? Oh damn it. What? This broke all of a sudden. In there. Oh. Messed that up. Okay, it's supposed to look like that. Yeah, so this is what the puzzle is supposed to be like. This is the optimal version of this puzzle. So the point is, this makes it different than most other puzzles in the game so far, because you have to come into this area from two different ways, right? If you come in this way, the shield can't bounce off of your thing because it hits the, it can bounce off you, but it can't bounce back and hurt the shield tower. So you have to come at it from all the way around. Light this thing on fire. And then you come back. And then you can let it hit you. So that's the optimal version of that puzzle. But there's going to be some worlds where it's not optimal. And it has to do some has to do some stuff to fix it. So, like the last world we were just in, Wizard. But let's try another world. Let's try Tuxedo. Let's try some more. I'm just going to try all these world seeds right here and see what this puzzle's like in all those worlds and see if it works in all of them. It should, because I think that logic's correct. Now I gotta find that puzzle. Okay, it's not that one. Oh, that's the secret. Okay, that's the one puzzle. Here it is. Okay, yeah, this is what it should look like. Okay, wait, because we have... Yeah, because we have the east path, and there's no south path, it has to put this whole... edge thing around here. So this one, you could solve this one without having to leave the area. If I could fix that bug which stops the fire from going sometimes. Okay, we'll try it on a different world. Let's try Bonobo. Bonobo? How do you pronounce Bonobo? Is it Bonobo? I don't know. What I'm looking for is like a north and a south. That would be a good one to try. Here we go. Okay, another east one. Damn it. Let's see another world. Okay, this is another beautiful one where it's an optimal puzzle. But once again, it's west and east. I want to see something with more, something I haven't seen before. Oh, Bonobo. Ah. Rhombus? Hey, save it anyway. Hey, cool. At least we have an east-west one now. So this one, you would have to come... Ooh, this is a really interesting one because you have to... look how far you have to traverse. You have to go down here, up here, here. Oh, this might be broken. Oh, it's not. This is weird, though. We got all these weird bushes. Oh, what the hell is going on here? Totally broken, almost broken, but not quite broken. Wow. Hey, and look, this has 666 entities right now. Oh, no way. The screen is broken, and there's 666 entities on this screen. Take a screenshot of that. That's epic. So, yeah, you have to walk a long ways to solve this puzzle. Kind of ideal. Just like in real life. I have transcended ordinary space-time. So yeah, this puzzle is pretty cool. I like that one like that. But let's try and find a world with north and south. I want to see if it would work. Okay, but that was rhombus. I need to make sure and know. This is rhombus. Z5. Is the game capped at 60? No, it's not. It's you can set your option as far whatever you want. So if you go here to video, I got it set at 30 because I'm live streaming right now. But yeah, if you're on Windows, you can go up to 90, 120, 240, or max. Max just completely takes the cap off and goes as fast as your computer can possibly allow. But yeah, and then If you're on Windows, you also have the option to disable VSync. You can't disable VSync on Windows on Mac, which I'm on, but like on Windows, disable your VSync and then you can set your FPS to whatever you want. Alright. So what's up? Okay, that's cool. Alright. That would have been a nice one to see. In fact, maybe I'll just hack it so this says you can't see it. Okay, so yeah, here we go. We got a north path. Yeah, and this is how it should be. If we have a north path, we need to have that this whole line around the edge. Okay, that works. Let's go set that other path. Yeah, totally. You said whatever you want. So I'm hacking it here in this world so we can see what a north only path. It's going to be the same thing. Actually, we already saw the north only path. Yeah, okay, so we've checked every single situation and they all work. Yes! Alright, Chaos, see you, man. Really, Teak? Whoa. Yeah, okay, so if we have a north path only, we need to have this line around it. Good. Done. Check it in, ship it. All right, we didn't need no number of openings. Look at this, this pattern right here. It's a long pattern. It took like an hour and a half to do that, but it works. Yes, well, I guess it will. Definitely is confirmed to be on iOS. Android's a maybe. We'll see how that goes. But yep, the Songbringer is definitely coming to iOS. It's always been coming to iOS since the Kickstarter. One of the goals of the Kickstarter was, one of the stretch goals was iOS support. So we hit that first stretch goal. So in honor of all those great backers, Songbringer is coming to iOS for sure. It's no challenge for a GTX 970. Yeah. Okay, this is done. Swordless Shield Puzzle 2 done. Dun 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 dun. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. I had to get started early today just to because I got a little hike I'm gonna go on this afternoon. So it's been, yeah, this has been a good start to this new swordless dungeon. Two of the puzzle patterns are done. One of these puzzles is really simple. You just push a little fire pillar, or you push a pillar to get. Was it this one? Yeah, let me show you guys this puzzle. Take that off. Yeah, thanks, Clone Geek. Yeah, so I'll leave you guys with this. This is the other puzzle that got done today. It's a super simple puzzle, really. So, like, if you're trying to stand on one side of this thing, it hits the bushes. But then if you get down here, you push that pillar out of the way, and then you can let it hit you. Puzzle solved. All Alright, so yeah. We'll see you guys next time. Tomorrow. Tomorrow's stream. Same wizard time. So once again, I appreciate you guys watching. Appreciate all your support. And see you next time. Have a good one, everybody.